Good morning. In this class, we will study the equation of motion of an electron in energy band. We will look into the motion of wave packet. We are considering the wave functions in a wave packet near the wave vector k. So the group velocity can be written as vg equal to d omega by dk. The energy E is equal to h bar omega. I am taking italics E for energy and the E for electric field. E is for representing electric field and this E for energy. So we can write omega as E by h bar. So d omega by dk will be 1 by h bar into d E by dk. So Vg equal to 1 by h bar into d E by dk. I am taking this as equation 1, or dE by dk equal to h bar vg. dE by dk, this can also be represented as vg equal to 1 by h bar into differential of del of E del k, where del k, the differential is with respect to k. Since we are dealing in k space, in one dimensional real space, del equal to d by dx. In k space, we are taking del k, d by dk, we are taking it as del k. This can also be represented as vg equal to 1 by h bar into del k e, or d e by dk equal to h bar into vg. Consider the work done by the electric field in delta t time. Delta t time, let delta s be the displacement, then we can write it as Vg into delta t. The work done is equal to change in energy, so we can take it as delta E. The work done in delta t time, I am taking it as delta E is equal to force into displacement. Displacement is Vg delta t. So delta E equal to F Vg delta t. This I am taking it as equation 2. E is a function of k, so we can write delta E as dou E by dou k into delta k. Dou E by dou k is same as dE by dk, so it is dE by dk into delta k. E is a function of k only, so it is dE by dk into delta k. So comparing these two equations, equations 2 and 3, we can write it as dE by dk del k equal to F Vg delta t. dE by dk, from this equation dE by dk equal to h bar Vg. So h bar Vg del k is equal to F Vg del t. Vg will get cancelled. So taking delta t to left side, we get h bar del k by del t is equal to F. Del k by del t, when delta t tends to 0, del k by del t can be written as dk by dt. So the equation of motion is, we will get the equation of motion as h bar dk by dt equal to F. Or we can write dk by dt, we can take it as k dot, so it is h bar k dot equal to F. This force is provided by applying an electric field E. So force F is equal to QE, for electron QE equal to minus E. So F is equal to minus EE. So this equation of motion can be written as h bar dk by dt is equal to minus EE. If we are applying both electric and magnetic field, then we can write F as Q into E plus V cross B. For electron, this will be minus C into E plus V cross B. So this equation of motion can be written as h bar dk by dt is equal to minus C into E plus V cross B. This is the equation of motion of electron. For identifying it as electron, we are writing the wave vector for electron, K, for electron as KE. So this is the equation of motion of electron in an energy band. Now we will write the equation of motion of a hole. This is the equation of motion of electron in a band. The equation of motion of a hole. We know that a hole is created when an electron jumps from valence band to conduction band. This is valence band, this is conduction band. Consider an electron from here jumps from valence band to conduction band. Then here the orbital is vacant. That vacant orbital is called a hole. The vacant position created in valence band is called a hole. We will write the equation of motion for this hole. Initial momentum of crystal is zero. So after creating electron hole pair, the total momentum should be zero. So we can write H bar K E plus H bar K S, that should be equal to zero. Or we can say K H equal to minus K E. Initially the electron at this position from A is transferring to the position B. So it is having a moment, having a wave vector KE, then the momentum of hole should be assigned to minus KE. If it is having minus 10 unit, then minus KE means it should be plus 10. So it will be assigned to a point somewhere here. At the point C, its value will be KH, which is equal to minus KE. So the momentum of the wave vector of hole will be minus KE. It should be assigned to a point at the point C, such that the total momentum of system should be conserved during transition. So the equation of motion, we can write this, we can change this equation of motion for all as KE equal to, KE is minus KH. Rewriting this equation, we can write H bar into d by dt of, instead of KE, we can write it as minus KH equal to minus E into E plus V cross B. This minus will get cancelled, so we can write the equation as d by dt of KH is equal to minus E, sorry, minus cancel each other, so E plus V cross B. Velocity of electron and velocity of hole are the same, so I am writing it as V here. So this is the equation of motion of hole. So comparing this equation with the equation of motion of electron, we can assume that the hole will behave like a particle with the charge plus C. So hole, actually hole is a vacant position in conduction band. It is a vacant orbital, but it can be considered as a particle. It can be considered as an apparent particle with the effective charge plus C. So hole, we are assuming it as a particle with the charge plus C, and its equation of motion is same as that of a particle with the plus C charge. Now we will study the effective mass. The block electrons, electrons in a band are behaving differently from the free electrons. So the electrons in a band, when we apply an electric external electric field, the electrons will behave as if its mass is equal to effective mass. Now we will determine the expression for effective mass. We know that the group velocity Vg equal to 1 by h bar into dE by dk. Equation number 1. Taking the differential with respect to t, dVg by dt equal to 1 by h bar into d by dt of dE by dk. E is a function of k, so we can write it as dVg by dt equal to 1 by h bar into dk by dt into d by dk of dE by dk. So it will be 1 by h bar dk by dt d square E by, sorry, it is d by dE by dk, d square E by dk square. From equation of motion we have h bar dk by dt is equal to F. So it can be written as dvg by dt is equal to 1 by dk by dt. From this equation, dk by dt equal to F by h bar. So it will be F by, here on h bar is there, F by h bar square d square E by dk square. dvg by dt is acceleration. So we know that acceleration is equal to force by mass. This mass is, we are taking it as effective mass. So acceleration equal to force by mass. So comparing these two equations, dvg by dt is acceleration, then force by mass. So 1 by m star will be represented by 1 by h bar square d square E by dk square. 1 by m star is equal to 1 by h bar square d square E by dk square, or we can write the effective mass as, we can write the effective mass as m star equal to h bar square by d square E by dk square. This is the effective mass in one dimensional case where the wave vector is k. If we take three dimension in Cartesian coordinate system, we can write the components of effective mass as, or we can write the effective mass tensor as 1 by m star mu nu equal to 1 by h bar square into d square E by d k mu d k nu, where mu and nu runs over 1, 2 and 3. Mu, when mu equal to 1, then it is x coordinate. Mu 1 means x component, mu 2 means, mu and nu equal to 1 means x component, 2 means y component, and 3 means z components. Now we will draw the variation of effective mass. First we will draw the band diagram. So this is band diagram, E versus K. We are drawing it in first Brillouin zone. So this boundary will be pi by A, plus pi by A, and here it will be minus pi by A. The band diagram is like this. Now we will draw the variation of dE by dk with k. So this point it is pi by A. dE by dk means the slope of this graph. This is E versus k graph. So dE by dk is slope of this graph. From here to here, here the, it is horizontal, so the slope is 0. So when we go from this point to here, the slope increases, and somewhere here the slope becomes maximum. At this point, the slope becomes maximum, and thereafter the slope decreases, and here it is horizontal, so the slope becomes 0. So when we draw the variation of slope of this graph for dE by dk against k, at this point the slope is 0, then the slope increases with the k and becomes maximum at this point. That point I am taking it as k0. Here also minus k0. So at point k0, the slope increases and slope becomes maximum, and thereafter slope decreases and becomes 0 at this point. In a similar way, it varies in the negative direction. So this is like this. We know that the group velocity vg is 1 by h bar into dE by dk. So this represents the variation of dE by dk. When we multiply it by a constant factor 1 by h bar, we will get the value of Vg. So the variation of Vg is same as that of variation of dE by dk. So this represents the variation of group velocity with k. Now we will draw the variation of d square E by dk square with k value. How can we draw the variation of d square E by dk square? D square E by dk square is d by dk of dE by dk. So the differential of this one, that means the slope of this graph is represented by d square E by dk square. When we draw the slope of this graph, at this point the slope is maximum, and from here to here the slope decreases, and at the topmost point the slope becomes zero. From here to here the slope, which is inclined in the downward direction, so the slope is negative. So when we draw the variation, at this point the slope is maximum, and from here to here slope decreases and reaches zero. Slope becomes zero at this point, then the slope increases in negative direction. In a similar way, the negative half we can draw like this. So this represents the variation of d square E by dk square. Now the effective mass is given by m star equal to h bar square by d square E by dk square. So it is the reciprocal of d square E by dk square multiplied by a factor h bar square. So take the reciprocal of this one, we will get the effective mass. Taking the reciprocal of this graph, so the y axis I am drawing m star and x axis it is k. Taking the reciprocal, if it is 5, its reciprocal will be 1 by 5. So it will be 0.5 or 0.2. So it will be somewhere here. Then from here to here, the d square E by dk square decreases and becomes 0 here. As d square E by dk square decreases, its reciprocal increases. At this point, d square E by dk square becomes 0. That means its reciprocal becomes infinite. So from here to here, the reciprocal increases, and when it equal to this k becomes equal to k zero, it becomes infinite. That point is called the inflection, point of inflection. At the point of inflection, it increases to infinite value. Here also the variation is like this. From here to here, it is in the negative side. At this point, it will be infinity, and from here to here, the reciprocal of this point will be a finite value, but it will be in the negative side. So from here to here, if I draw, it will start from infinity, minus infinity, then it will reach a finite point in negative value. So the reciprocal of this curve is represented by this one. Like that, we can draw the reciprocal here. That means, so this last graph represents the variation of effective mass, with the k value. So this graph, it is clear that in this point the effective mass is positive. So it is positive, and this region effective mass is negative. Here also effective mass is negative. Negative effective mass is when k increases beyond k0. When k increases beyond k0, the mass becomes negative. That means it is near the boundary. For higher values of energy, when k becomes greater than k0, the energy is high. So in the topmost levels of the band, the effective mass is negative. For higher energy, the effective mass is negative. And for lower energy, the effective mass is positive. When the electron reaches the zone boundary, this is first Brillouin zone. So this is zone boundary. When it reaches the boundary of the Brillouin zone, the effective mass becomes negative. Negative effective mass means that the electrons are, instead of accelerating,
In the presence of an external electric field, the electrons are decelerated. This deceleration is happening when the momentum transferred from electron to the lattice is less than the momentum transferred from external field to the electron. So the net change will be decrease in momentum. If the momentum is decreasing, that means the electron is decelerated. This can be explained by the reflection at the zone boundary or at a Bragg plane. When the electron reaches the Bragg plane, due to reflection at a zone boundary, standing waves are produced. So the electrons are decelerated near the zone boundary, which means that the effective mass is negative. So upward curvature means d square E by dk square is positive. So in this case, if it is curved upwards, then it is its effective mass is positive. Here the curvature is upward, and when k reaches beyond k0, the curvature is downward. Downward curvature means the effective mass is negative. That means we can have both positive effective mass and a negative effective mass. If the energy in a band depends slightly on k, if E depends slightly on k, then we can write d square E by dk square nearly zero. So m star is very, very large. So m star is very, very greater than m. In that case, the electrons will be more or less bound to the atom. There is least probability of tunneling electron from one atomic position to another atomic position. Or we can say that 1 by m star, from this equation, 1 by m star equal to 1 by h bar square into d square E by dk square. So d square E by dk square, actually it represents in an E versus k graph, d square E by dk square represents the radius of curvature. Or we can write the radius of curvature as 1 by r approximately equal to d square E by dk square. So r represents the radius of curvature of curve. If I take point like this, then its radius of curvature is determined. Radius of r represents its radius of curvature. That means the effective mass is proportional to radius of curvature. If we are having a highly curved surface, then its center will be near to the surface. That means its radius of curvature is less. In the case of highly curved surface, the radius of curvature is less. That means we are having less R value. We have shown that M star is proportional to radius of curvature of curve. If we are having less radius of curvature, its effective mass will be less. So if we have a band with a high curvature, its radius of curvature is less, so its effective mass will be less. If we are having slightly curved surfaces, then its radius of curvature will be large. If R is large, its effective mass will be large. If we are having a flat surface means E does not depend, E is depending on K slightly, then we are having huge effective mass. Now we will draw the band diagram for a direct semiconductor. In the case of a direct semiconductor, the band diagram can be drawn. This is K, E, conduction band, valence band. In valence band, if you are having two bands like this, valence band, this is representing hole. So this represents light hole. Its effective mass is less compared to the hole in this band. This is heavy mass. It is heavy hole, and this one is light hole. Because for heavy mass, its radius of curvature is less, so its radius of curvature is large. So the effective mass will be large. So a hole in this band will be having effective mass greater than a hole in this band. Then in semiconductors, we are having one more band. It is called SOH. Split of hole, that is due to spin orbit splitting of bands. This value we are taking it as delta. The energy of different bands can be written as the energy of an electron in conduction band. I am writing it as EE. It can be written as this: topmost level, I am writing it as EC. So it can be written as EC plus h bar square k square by 2 effective mass of electron to me star, or we can write the effective mass of electron as me. So it will be electron energy of electron in conduction band. This is conduction band at EC plus h bar square k square by 2 me, where me represents the effective mass of electron in conduction band. In a similar way, the effective mass of hole in valence band can be written as EH equal to valence band top, I am taking it as EV. So EV plus h bar square k square by 2 m star. But we know that the effective mass of hole is negative. Effective mass of hole is negative. M star is equal to, m star is negative, so I am writing it as m star equal to minus mh, where mh is its magnitude, so it will be a positive quantity. So this equation can be written as eh equal to ev minus h bar square k square by 2 mh. So this value, it will represent a positive quantity. This minus I am taking here. The effective mass of hole is negative, and here this ms will be a positive quantity. Minus is taken here. So E energy of hole is EV minus h bar square k square by 2 ms. If I take, in this case I have drawn the zero energy at the topmost level of valence band. If I draw the zero energy at the topmost level of valence band, we can write it as E whole is equal to, EV is equal to 0 in this case, so it will be minus h bar square k square by 2 mh. EH proportional to minus k square, that's why it is curved downwards. Or we know that the effective mass of hole is negative, holes are present at the valence band, its effective mass is negative, so the curve will be the band will be curved in the downward direction. If the band is curved in the downward direction, then its effective d square e by d k square will be negative. So it we will be having negative effective mass. That's why it is E equal to EH equal to minus h bar square k square by 2 mh. For light hole, we can write it as minus h bar square for light hole LS minus h bar square k square by 2 mLS. For heavy hole also, we can write it as EHH equal to minus h bar square k square by 2 mHH. For split of hole, we can write it as ESOH, split of hole, minus here delta value is there, that is spin orbit splitting. So it is minus delta minus h bar square k square by 2 mSOH, where effective mass of SOH is the effective mass of split of holes. In a similar way, the energy of electrons in conduction band can be written as EC, EE equal to EC plus H bar square K square by 2 ME. Here EC, if I take the topmost level of valence band as zero energy, then this energy level difference will be equal to the energy gap. So I can write EC as EG. So electron, the energy of electron in conduction band EE as EG plus H bar square K square by 2 ME, where ME is the effective mass of electron and MH is the effective mass of hole.